I talked about Java just as a programming language, but computers can't understand Java as it's written. Computers understand these really, really small instructions. A line of Java code can correspond to a lot of instructions that the computer has to run. So there's this thing called the compiler that sits in the middle. This takes the code that we can read, like the human readable Java code, and it translates it into Java bytecode. Eventually it gets turned into something called like assembly and then an actual binary. The point is, this compiler is the thing that's gonna look through all your code. It's gonna tell you if it doesn't understand something. It might warn you and just say like, I don't think this is what you mean to do. And if you see something like that, always listen to it, don't ignore it. Warnings are usually gonna save you hours of headaches later. This is the outline of just what a Java program looks like. Just this sequence of things. Doesn't necessarily need to make a ton of sense right now. Class, capital, and main we have to write because inside of REPL, we are inside of a file that REPL created for us called main.java. If you were to work on your own inside of IntelliJ and you had a program called hello, it would be class hello instead of class main. This would just need to match the name of the file that you're in. This public static void main string args here. The only thing I really want you to remember is this lowercase m main. This is actually like a special thing to Java. This lowercase m main is where you tell the computer, this is where I want you to start running my code. You can write code in different places, but this is where it will begin running. So right now we just have this main. Our program is empty. So if we ran this, nothing would happen. Any line of code that starts with two slashes is called a comment. This is stuff where you make notes to yourself or other programmers. The compiler will just throw these out. If it sees a line starting with those two slashes, it just ignores it. Another form of comment is slash star, which can span multiple lines. Just so you know these two exist, whatever thing you're using to write code will highlight it different as I have it grayed out here. So a line starting with two slashes is a comment that just goes to the end of the line. And a line starting with a star slash or a star slash appearing anywhere in the line will go as a comment until the next star slash. I would say just use these slash slash comments, but if you're like working on something for this class and you want to just make a note of what you think something does, or if you want to send me code to look over for you and you want to keep track of what you think it does or what you're trying to do or what's not working, this is a great way to put information like that into your program. This next part, system.out.println, the thing we use to write stuff to the user, like println, short for line. So you give it some text inside of quotes. The quotes are very important here, followed by a semicolon, because every one of our lines of code that we call a statement has to end with a semicolon. If you don't, you're gonna get something really confusing later on. System.out.println. Parentheses, and then whatever you want to print out. When I say print, I mean, these are like command line applications. I'm sure you've all seen a command line at some point. When like your computer boots up, things kind of just show up line by line. This is the kind of interface we're talking about. This is just a program that you run it. It says hello world and it exits. And things to note is these parentheses here. That's you telling print line what you want to print. These quotes are telling you what is between the quotes, that is text. It will treat things in between those double quotes as text. If you didn't have quotes here, it's going to try to treat this as code. And this doesn't mean anything. So you don't want to do that. So first slide, this is the first Java program. First program many of you are seeing at all. Anyone have any questions about just anything up here? System.out is the standard out. Stream. Printline is how you print too. That's like the interface that Stream provides. So you can write your own function that wraps that, but no, there's nothing built in. If you just wrote println, it wouldn't know what you were talking about, right? So the print function in Python is a built-in. So it's in the global namespace. In this case, system.out is an object and you're calling println on that object. If you called println like just without anything, it would look for a function with that name. So we have a few people in this class that have programs before, which is good, but the vast majority of you have either written like one line of code or have written zero. So when you hear questions like this, I don't want you to think like, oh man, I'm so far behind already, because these people are the exceptions. What is this? Why do I have it so big? You need to end all of your statements with semicolons. Notice that on this one, these lines that end with braces, they don't have semicolons on them because they're not considered statements. We could talk about what it means to be a statement later on, but right now, everything that's inside of your main, like every time you write something that you want it to do, like here's an action, print this thing, that is considered a statement, and you always have to end with semicolons. If you don't, you're gonna get something really cryptic. Try to drill this into your heads, semicolons at the end of your statements. Lab 1.1, all right. So go into REPL. If you go into the classroom, you should see a few labs that are out in lab 1.1, 1.2, 1.3. If you hit run, you should just be able to see what it does. If you hit run test, it'll test your output to make sure it's printing something that looks like the right thing. This right here is a lowercase l. It is not a capital I. So system.out.println is how we say this. Output, you'll see something if you run the test and it fails, we'll say like teacher expected this \W+. What it literally means is any alphabetic character one or more times. That line that says your code here with the two slashes, you can delete that or you can just write on the next line. It doesn't matter. That's just me showing you this is where you should be writing. Good job, everybody. You are now all programmers. Give yourselves a round of applause. And the next thing I want to talk about is these integers. So everything inside of quotes is treated like text. We call those things strings. It's like a string of letters. It's capital S string, this string here. That's just the name of the type of thing. Things like this, like just a numeric value, is called an int, an integer, a whole number. 20 is an integer, 10,000 is an integer, 0 is an integer, negative 5 is an integer, int. Now saying integer, but the type is called just int with int. So you can do math with them. So you can tell the computer, like, add 20 and 5, and this line will print out 25, and this line will print out 42. They do not have quotes around them because they are not text. They are numbers. All right, 1.2. One thing to note is you can do, like, 5 plus 6 plus 7. It's going to do it like 5 plus 6, and it's going to add 7 to it. It'll follow, like, the regular mathematics association rules. So if you did 5 plus 2 times 7, it's going to do 2 times 7 first. These are our plus we've already seen, minus the star, the asterisk, is the operator for multiplication. It's not an X. You might have seen if you've like Googled multiplication problems, you probably know this by now. So that'll print out 60 there. Division stuff is a little funky. Like I said, integers are just for whole numbers. So when you divide two integers, the result is also a whole number. So it just drops the remainder. So like 9 divided by 2 is 4, because 9 over 2 is 4.5, but it just truncates it, meaning it just chops off that half. If I did 9 divided by 5, I'm just gonna get 1. We're just gonna get our integer without the remainder. But what if we want the remainder? We use this operator, the percent, which is called modulus, or we call it mod for short. So you would read this line here as 9 mod 2, 7 mod 4. Why do we use percent? Because we weren't using it for anything else. Yeah, this is useful for a lot of things that aren't immediately obvious. We will certainly get to that. Do lab 1.3. You can have multiple statements. This will be the first lab that I will need you to write, like system.out.println and then something else after it. Make sure whatever comes after it is still within these two braces at the end. Make sure the first one is within these braces. Your code has to come in between this and this.